Sir Edward Lee.
Number seven, sir.
Mr. Speaker, my honourable friend asked what discussions the Secretary of State has had with Cabinet colleagues about the Irish backstop, and I think the short answer is a lot. The country and this Parliament seems to have been discussing little else for weeks, and it's the same with knobs on for the Cabinet.
Sir Edward Lee, surely never has something so important, namely Brexit, been put at risk in preventing something that will never happen, namely a hard border in Northern Ireland. Why don't the EU, the Republic and the United Kingdom government simply attach an instrument to the withdrawal agreement, making clear that we will never impose a hard border in Northern Ireland? And this can be achieved in time and in goodwill, first with customs arrangements and then with a free trade deal backed by technology. It's so simple. Let's do it.
Well, Mr. Speaker, my honourable friend raises a creative potential legal solution, which I think he's already discussed in an adjournment debate 2 weeks ago. The whole House will know that the Attorney General is currently involved in detailed negotiations over how to modify the backstop in line with Parliament's wishes, and ultimately it must be for him to judge whether or not my honourable friend's proposal gets him closer to a legally effective solution which would allow him to change his advice. I will make sure he's aware of it so he can incorporate it if it is worthwhile.
We'll get the right honourable gentleman in. We had him down as coming in on question seven. If that's not his wish, we'll do our best to accommodate the right honourable gentleman, of course. Mr. Gregory Campbell.
Mr. Speaker, in discussions with ministerial colleagues, can the minister indicate if they are indicating to him that at this very late stage in discussions with the European Union, there is a sliver of light beginning to emerge that they understand the need for fundamental change to the backstop?
Well, Mrs. Speaker, I suspect that is well above my pay grade, I'm sorry to say. But also, I'm sure that we will all want to hear what the Attorney General and the Prime Minister have to say when it comes to the meaningful vote next Tuesday.
Mr. Ranald, yeah.